Hey bot builders, Matthew here at Botpress. Today I'll be teaching you a really cool feature, which is how to connect your Botpress AI chatbot to your Zendesk knowledge base. So basically syncing any published articles you have on your Zendesk to an AI chatbot that you've created in the studio. So let's go to our studio. Here we have an empty bot. Haven't added anything. I'm just waiting for it to load. And so first things first, what you're going to do is when creating this fresh bot is you're going to go to the bottom left at installed integrations. You're going to click find more on the hub. You're going to search for Zendesk and you're going to install it. You're going to click the install button. Once you click the install button, you should be seeing a page like this, or basically you're going to have to configure your Zendesk integration, and I'll go over how to do that real quick. So firstly, they're going to ask you for your organization subdomain. So when you go to Zendesk here, in your URL, you should see your organization subdomain .zendesk.com. So what you're going to do is you're just going to grab that part, copy paste it into here. Then you're going to be using the email that you used for your Zendesk account. Then you're going to use your Zendesk API token. Now I will show you how to get that. So what you're going to do is you're going to go back to Zendesk, go to your settings, go to the admin center, go to apps and integrations, click on Zendesk API, click on add an API token. You don't need a description. I normally put something random. And then copy your API token. Make sure you store this somewhere, because once you click save, you will never see your API token ever again. So make sure you have that, click save, and then you're going to paste that in here. Now it's going to ask you for your knowledge base ID. So what this basically means is first and foremost, click save configuration before we write anything here. Let's click save configuration. Wait for it to finish saving. And then what you're going to do is you're going to go create a new knowledge base on Botpress. You could call it whatever you'd like. I'm gonna call it Zendesk testing. And what happens is, once again, we're going to be looking at our URL. And so the way we do it here at Botpress is at the end of your URL, you should see KB, which stands for knowledge base, dash a random string of characters. And so we're going to copy this and go to Zendesk and just put it in here. Oh, and moreover, make sure you have sync knowledge base with bot checked. And now click save configuration again. And so let's go back and let's refresh our page. And while we're at it, let's go back to Zendesk, and we should go to, if I remember correctly, it's knowledge/list. Yeah. And this is where you should see all your published articles and be able to add other ones. And so here we can see I created three articles on real estate. So three randomly generated articles. To be quite honest with you, they're not real. I used an AI to generate them. So we have real estate financing options, real estate listings, real estate regulations. So if we go back now to my knowledge base, we can see that the three articles that I had published are now here. But now let's see what happens if I unpublish one of them. Basically, I'm going to be showing you the sync feature that we've created. So if I unpublish this and I go back and I refresh my page, it should have disappeared. As you can see, we only have two articles now. Now if I go back and I republish this and I refresh the page again, it should be back. As you can see, it's back. So now what we're going to do is we're also going to show the syncing feature with the content in itself. So here we have the content. So let's open, which one is this? Okay, let's open real estate financing options for homes in Montreal, whatever. So yeah, we have that open already. So we have introduction, bunch of content, mortgage, bunch of content. Okay, so here's what the content looks like when it's put into our knowledge base. And so what I'll do is I'll just add a random line and I'll go for fun. And I'll click save. And now it's been published. So let's just refresh this. Okay, publish this minute. Now let's refresh again. And so as you can see, these two were created 2 minutes ago, and this one was created 59 seconds ago because it was just updated. And if we go, we should see our header of random malarkey at the top. And so now let's just go remove that, obviously. And so as you can see, our syncing feature works. So basically, we've synced all of the article, all of the published articles on our Zendesk to Botpress. And now the reason why this is important is because now we can have an AI agent that basically that does work for us with this now information that it can access. And I'll show you how it can access this information, creating a very simple bot. It's going to use one autonomous node, and we're just going to go over how this will work. So this is my start node, this is my end node. I'm going to link my start node to an autonomous node, and I'm going to give the autonomous node some instructions. I have some written over here. Let me just copy paste them. So basically, I'm telling the autonomous node, answer questions by looking through the articles within the knowledge base. If the user states to end the conversation, take the transition card. So basically, what does this mean? I'm going to add a card that says search knowledge. So it's going to search the knowledge base. And I'm going to sync it. I'm going to sync it with the Zendesk testing. Yes. Which is the one we had just created together. And that should be good. Yeah, that's it. I'm not going to add instructions here. And for the advanced options, that's fine. Now I'm going to add a card, and I'm going to call it transition. So basically, it's a way of leaving the autonomous node. And I'm going to sync it, or rather, I'm going to link it to the end node. And I'm going to say that the condition for leaving this node is that the user states to end the conversation. And so now we've created a very simple bot that will go through this knowledge base that I've stored on Zendesk and synced with Botpress, answer whatever questions I need. And when I say that I want to end the conversation will end. So let's test that to make sure that that works. So I said hi to the bot. The bot says, hello, how can I assist you today? And so now I'm going to say, I don't know exactly what I wrote here because it was generated, but let's see if we can ask it questions, very specific questions on these articles to see if it will hallucinate or if it will actually answer my questions properly, meaning that it actually does have access to the knowledge base. So let's go take a look. So if I go to real estate regulations, let me ask it something that, here. So what are the tenant and landlord regulations? What document is this part of? Real estate regulations for residential properties in Montreal. Okay, so if I ask it, what are the tenant, let me copy paste that, I won't remember. What are the tenant and landlord regulations? And let's see if it gets it accurately. So it says lease agreements, rent control, and evictions. In Montreal, tenant and landlord regulations are designed to protect tenant rights, blah, 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 blah. Let's make sure that this is real. So we have 3 points here. Are those 3 points accurate? So we have evictions, rent control, and lease agreements. Perfect. And as you can see here, it has the description pretty well. Yes, it's accurate. It even got the proper government, so it's governed by the règlement, yes, sur les baux résidentiels. And if we go here, perfect. So as we can see, it's not hallucinating. Let's see if it has access to another article, just to ensure that this works. Let's look at real estate financing options. Let's grab what are the eligibility criteria for mortgage loans? Sure. What are the eligibility criteria for mortgage loans? Okay. I think that's how I would ask that question, right? Mortgage loans eligibility criteria should be. Okay. So proof of income, good credit score, debt to income ratio, down payment, proof of income and yeah. Okay. Good credit score. Yep. Yep. It's perfect. See? No hallucinations. It has access to the articles. And now let's just make sure it takes our transition state. Let's say end the conversation. And as we can see here, it says conversation has ended. And as you can see, end has been highlighted, which means that we have officially ended our conversation. And that concludes the video. Hope you enjoyed. I'll see you on the next one.